Hey everyone, welcome back to another Figma tutorial. In the last video, we saw a glimpse of what auto layout can do. In today's video, we will dive deep and master all the auto layout techniques. By the end of this video, you'll be able to create dynamic buttons, tags, lists, dropdowns, alerts, calendar, and cards. It will be great if you can follow along. Timestamps are added in the description so that you can easily skip or repeat specific topic. Let's get started. You can add auto layout to any design element in three ways. Take this text as an example. Just right click on this layer, click on add auto layout from the list. Figma automatically applies the padding to the layer. The second way is to select existing frame or add a layer inside a frame. Click on auto layout in the properties panel on the right hand side. That's it. The third way is to select two layers or frames at a time and then clicking the auto layout. Now this time, Figma auto detects the orientation, padding and spacing, which is super convenient. Once auto layout frame is created, we can change the orientation as horizontal and vertical. You can also choose to keep height or width to auto or fixed. On the second row, you can change horizontal padding, vertical padding and spacing between two elements. In this section, we'll create some standard components using horizontal orientation. Creating dynamic size buttons takes only few clicks. Add auto layout to text layer, tweak padding values, and change fill and corner radius if required. You can also add any other layer inside it, like adding an icon or some shape. Creating tags is precisely the same as buttons. You can add or remove icons to create different variations. This can also be used to create evenly spaced website menu bar. Another typical design element that we see nowadays is Instagram stories. You can create this easily by creating two circles, adding them inside a frame, and applying auto layout. In this section, we'll create some standard designs using vertical orientation. Let's start with to-do list. Just add a checkbox and label. Add both of them inside a frame and duplicate the selection. Add auto layout by selecting both of them together. You can add as many checklist items as you want. Rearrange them without worrying about adjusting spacing every time. Similar to to-do list is our chat list, email list, or comments list. Start by adding a circle for avatar image, text label, and description field. Add everything inside a frame and create duplicate. Add auto layout and duplicate it enough times to complete the design. You can also create simple drop-down lists like auto suggest, menu selection, and sorting options. All you have to do is add text inside a frame and create auto layout. Duplicate it and you can also change fill and shadows to give it a drop-down look and feel. Just like frames, you can also nest auto layout, or in simple words, add one auto layout inside another. Check out the first example of creating input forms. I have already added a label, input field, and a hint text. Add everything inside auto layout frame. Now this input will have a dynamic height. Duplicate this. Select both the inputs and add them into another auto layout. This is called as nesting. This allows us to create super flexible designs. You can just hide the layers which are not required, and the form will adapt itself in no time. The next common component is alerts. Here are three types of alerts from Material UI guidelines. You can create them using just one design using auto layouts. Here are the steps to do it. First, add title and description in auto layout. Second, create two text buttons in auto layout. The next step is to select both of them together and nest them inside another auto layout frame. Make sure that orientation is set to vertical and alignments are proper. Duplicate this alert two times to create different variations, like in this examples. Just hide the title to create second variation. All you have to do is change orientation of buttons from horizontal to vertical to create third variation. Now you can go and listen your favorite song using the time you just saved. Creating custom calendar is super easy and fun with auto layout. Start with one text layer inside a frame. Use constraints to align it to the center. Duplicate and add both the layers inside auto layout. Duplicate to create 7 columns. Now select entire row and create a copy. Add both of them together in auto layout and make sure that orientation is set to vertical. Duplicate row to create 6 rows. The last step is to modify days and dates. You can change the text color and background color to highlight today's date or selection, etc. Pause this video here and give it a try. I'm pretty sure that you will be able to create your custom calendar under 1 minute. If you observe closely, you will see that all above design examples have equal padding on the horizontal or vertical axis. There are few instances where you need different padding on top and bottom, like this card example. To create this correctly, you need to understand the anatomy or structure of this card. Let's start by adding a title and description. Copy tag element we created earlier for time slots. Frame the title and slots together. The next step is to add a text button. Add image on the top with proper aspect ratio. Now if you add everything inside auto layout, it will add padding around the image too. So the hack here is to add separate padding for card content, say 15 pixels on all the sides. Use 0 padding on outermost auto layout frame. Done. Now our dynamic card with different padding is ready. As you can see, Figma auto layout is an incredibly powerful tool. It saves hours and hours in complex projects. That's it for today. Hit like if this video was helpful and consider subscribing to this channel to stay notified about the next tutorials on Figma. If you want to suggest a new topic or have feedback, let me know in the comments below. Thanks for watching it. I'll see you in the next one.